Hi everybody, I'm going to show you how I make these coin wings, so stay tuned. Alright. Now, this is actually my first US coin wing I made. I've been making a whole bunch of foreign coins. As you can see here, I've been selling them. Now, when you go make coin wings, you want one of these wing sizes. That way you know what size to make. Like I know I can wear 11. You probably can't see it, but there's numbers up here at top and goes in half size on this particular one. Goes all the way from 1 to 13. I got a 2015 coin here for Louisiana. It's not a state quarter, it looks like a national park quarter. So how I'm gonna do this, I got one of these center punch cards I got from a King's Coin Wings Tools over at Etsy. Now this is a new one he's making. It can do a total of 6 different coins, from dimes all the way up to half dollars. And it comes with a whole bunch of these discs with different size holes in them. Now, the quarters, for the quarter size, it comes with 3 different discs, because the quarters are actually the more common ones. There they are. Oh. And yeah, those only have about 2 each. So what I like to do is figure out how much of that detail I want on that coin. Now on the this one, I used the wash that had the smallest hole so I can keep most of the detail. That's what it looked like. Now, get this all cleaned up. Now when you get this card set, you actually get a spacer and barely see it right there on the bottom. And you can see it better than between the steel block and the washer there. That way you have enough space to put your card in there. And how you do this, Take the washer, lay down on the surface, and push down on it until it snaps. Take a coin, lay down the table again, flip the card over, and push it on there. Now make sure it doesn't move around on you, because if it does, it could give you an offset or hole. If it's loose, one thing you can do is take a piece of paper towel and sandwich the coin in between the get the paper towel sandwiched in between the coin and the card and push it down on there. You can tell this ain't scripted. Now we got a coin and the card here. What we need to do is find the punch we need for this. Now this is the Harbor Freight set, and this should be a 3/8, and it is. As you can see there. Now this kit also comes with some O-rings. Now you put those onto your punch, and these will help keep the punch aligned when it's in the die set. Now what I do is I have this little cup here I put underneath the press here. As you can see, I have a whole bunch of center pieces in there already. So I get everything lined up. Now we need to find the hole we need. Gonna be there in the middle. Now you wanna make sure you got this punch in there. Well, it needs to be, because if you're not locked in, you could damage your card or that washer on there. It's locked in. Before we do that, we need to put a little bit ball save on there. This just helps lubricate it. Get that O-ring down in there. Make sure your punch is standing straight up, and slowly bring the ram down until it goes through. There we go. Sometimes it does that. Get the press blocks out of the way and finish it off. Ooh. Now you have to take a smaller punch and push that bigger one all the way through because it's stuck. There we go. Get everything put away here for a moment. See if I can find that centerpiece here, and I don't see it. Well, that's in there. Now we got a hole punched. Lay that to the side. One thing I like to do to make sure this is as close to center as possible is take a pair of calipers. Hook onto one side of it and put the set screw on and just go around and make sure we got as close to center as possible. It looks pretty good. I got one of these deboring tools. Go with that. Take down that cut edge there. Now this does a couple things. One, it takes down the ball so you don't cut yourself on it. And it also takes care of any cracks that may have formed. Now, if you're dealing with a silver coin, you want to keep your shavings from everything because silver is worth money. We don't want to lose that. Now, these are just clatter coins. Now, at this point, got one of these dapping blocks here. And I know that particular hole there will fit quarters. Now what we need to do is anneal this coin. I got one of these big pliers here. Grab the coin in it. Light the torch. Now you want to get these coin wings to where they start to glow. We don't want to melt it, but we want it to get it to glow. To a sort of a dull red color. Look good. That looks good. Dip in the water. And now it's annealed. dried off a little bit. Now, when you do this, you need to look at the coin and see what side you want facing outwards. Now, the way I like to do it, put the most interesting side out, which in this case also has the date on it. So we just make sure we got that side facing down in the block here. Now there's easier ways to cone these coins over, but I don't have the tools to do that just yet. This is actually an older way of making coin wings. Now you can actually use an arbor press to do this, but the 6-ton hydraulic sharp press from a Harbor Freight does a pretty good job. Plus it gives you the muscle behind the cutter if you need it. Now it is coned over. Make sure you still have a smooth edge there and feel a high spot. Now the comp method I use is could actually rub away the inside detail, but there's methods to protect the inside, and some of the tools that I plan on getting a little bit later on will actually help with that. I'm just taking care of any nicks that could be an issue. You just want to make sure you get all the cracks out of them, because they could split on you and destroy the coin. Now it looks good. Let's see if we can get onto the size of here. And no, not quite yet. When you're first getting started, you'll have some of these problems. If I get that hole big enough. Sometimes this is easier than looks. Sometimes it's not. That was just a game of millimeters here. Now, depending on what size you punch the hole out to be, depending on how much trouble you're going to have when you're getting started with this. Now you can actually go on eBay and both eBay and Etsy and get all kinds of tools you need. Like, I got the sizing machine here from eBay, and this is from eBay. I think I got the torch head off of there too. This press came from Harper Freight. So close. Now, if I had some of the other tools, I wouldn't have this problem. But all I need is get right on the edge in there. Oh, there we go. Snug, but it's on there. Now we can slowly increase its size. Until we get down past that spring there. That spring holds the individual wedges on here. Now, when you come down on the handle and release the coin, you want to rotate a little bit so you ain't putting the force on the same spot, because that could actually damage the coin itself, because you're focusing all that pressure on the same spot over and over, and that could be bad. In fact, it will be bad. You notice how that coin's starting to fold over? We want to stop every so often, make sure we don't have any splits or cracks forming. Now it starts to get hard to form it, or you're thinking you might have a crack forming. One thing you can do to take care of the crack is either the deboring tool or a small needle file. This is a half round one. And just go around on the inside and file it, and on the end there too. That'll take care of any cracks that might be starting up. Now, you can re-nail the coin. Soften it up again. Same way. Now some of these coins that I've done, like these are Mexican coins. They're two different metals though. The outside piece of it is actually steel, so I have to deal with those a little bit differently, but the process is still the same. We just keep on forming this. All the while spinning the coin around. See how far it went down when we couldn't get on top earlier, and we're almost there. I got the coin flipped over. And all the time still checking we have no cracks. Taking care of any high spots we might have. And we're sitting about an 8. But we're still not finished. Because we still have a bit of a cone shape here. Now, this particular unit, a coin sizer, has a reduction die on it. So we can put the coin lead side down, which is the side that has the cone on it. And gently apply pressure. To help start bringing that bottom end inwards. And the other coin again. That coin is almost done. Now I can tell we actually squeezed down a little bit too much. The lead size on the 6, flip it over, is about the same size there. Try to keep it as even as possible. I was back down to the 8. Now one way to increase the size of these a little bit is take the inside lip that lead and help and remove it a little bit. That would actually increase the size a little bit. Now I can still see we still have a little bit of that cone, so I face it downward a little. Try to bring some of the cone out of it. And that's how I normally make my coin wings. Now this one's measuring about 6.5 there. 6.25 there. Take off a little bit more of that lip. And try to get to that 6.5 on both ends. Now that side there shows it 6.5. But now we're down there 7 the other way. And well, it was a pinky wing. It's a little tight on my pinky. That was a 7. Yeah, that's a 6.5. So I say that'd be a 7. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna set up to clean and polish this. Now I know this video might be taking longer than some of the others, but a lot of the videos that you probably have seen by now, they haven't showed the whole process, especially what I'm fixing to show you, the cleaning and polishing. So I'll be right back in a minute. Okay, we're back. Now you probably recognize this from a previous video I just did. There's the flex shaft. I'll put a link at it for it at the end of the video. So here's the coin wing. Now I got a wild brush in this at the moment. I'm gonna go clean up some of this file scale. At least try to. Now this might get a little bit loud. Probably not as loud as the hydraulic press here, oil. But here we go. That handle's getting hot. Now this is the first time I've used this shaft, so it's being used for the first time. As you can see, that cleaned it up quite a bit. It's not a polish, but it's a lot cleaner. And clean it up like this, it actually will help you out on the polishing step in a few minutes. Now to change these bits out, for this guy, you have this little pin heel. You line the hole up, lock into place so it doesn't turn on you. Got one of these. Get it loosened up. There you go. Now what I like to do next is take one of these drum sandals and help smooth off any high spots, and especially on the cut edge. Just to speed down a little. That helps soften up that edge there so it doesn't rub against your finger. I did both inside and outside on both sides. Now this tends to leave a little bit of a harsh edge, so we need to smooth it off. Because these particular wheels I have, they're coarse. So what we'll do is we'll go on these paper sanding disc, now you'll find you'll go through these a lot. Now what that did was it actually smoothed out all the high spots that the drum sander left. As you can see, that was a brand new disc. Now we got the polishing wheel here, or felt pad. Now this is what I use, mag and aluminum polish from Mothers. This is automotive polish. But it does a fantastic job on a coin wings. Now the one problem I might have with this stuff, it actually splatters. everywhere. So I got a paper towel here that I'll use to keep that splatter down when I start up the tool here. And you don't need that much. Because if it ain't enough, you just go back and get a little bit more. I don't know if you can tell, but you can barely see where I've actually polished that. Right in there. Not polished. Polished. Now, just so you know, these do get hot when you start to polish them. They get quite a bit harder when you're polishing them than you are for these other tools. So I got one of these. These are ink holders. There's a couple different versions that you can get off of eBay, Amazon. I know Rio Grande, which is a big jewelry company that sells stuff like this, would have them. But what I do, grab a hold of the coin at the end. Not designed to do that, but I do it anyways. Get a little bit more polish on here. Go at it. Thank you. I'm just getting the bulk of the polishing compound and what's left of the dirt off of here. And see how nice and shiny that coin is now, both inside and out. Now what I do is I'll take a short video of the finished coin in a better lighting conditioning and with a little bit better camera so I can get a nice close-up image. So stay tuned. Okay, before we get to the close-up to the coin rings, what I decided to do is show y'all how I make these earrings here. Now these earrings are actually made out of these scrap centers of the coins. And how I made these, I take the centers, I get punched out and put them onto this painter's tape. I speed this up a little. I normally put two or three at a time, and I try to find the centers at about equal in size. I normally do the top ones larger, the bottom ones smaller. I line them up with the smallest hole on this punch. And go from there. Grab the punch. Put a little bit of lube on it. And punch it out. Knock the punch all the way through and set up for the next hole. Which will be about straight down from the previous one. As you can see, that dropped down. Bit more lube. Now both those holes have been punched out. All I'm going to do is go finish these off. And we'll be right back. Now as you can see, I got all the holes punched. Got two in the big ones and one in the little small ones. Now what we need to do is clean these holes up. Problem is, that won't be easy with the deboring tool. So I have to file them down, get them cleaned up. And once I get that done, we'll be back. Okay. Now I got these cleaned up and deballed. What I need to do now is clean them up, polish them. I got the polishing wheel here. And go at it. Get a couple plows here. These are the same type. What we're gonna do, we need some jump rings. These are 8mm stainless steel. What we do is find the cut, put plows on either side of it, get one good twist, take one of our centers, put on there, take another one with the two holes, put it on. Close it up. Got another jump ring. Same thing. Open it up. This time we're going to take a Ellingdale. Forgot what those are called. These particular ones. Put it on there. Take that whole thing. Put it together. And twist that jet wing together. And there you go. Now just repeat that for the other one. Easy as that. They have a complete set. As you can tell, and do almost any color combination of, as long as you have the coins to do it. Now only thing you have to do is put the earrings on a earring card, and if you want to, you can sell them. I'm thinking about selling these for $5 a set. So let's move on to the close-up of the wings and earrings. So be back in a minute. Here's the close-up of the earrings and coin wings I made in the video. I know the video is longer than I was hoping to make it, but I hope it's helpful. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And don't forget to leave a comment or question down below. I'll catch you on the next one.